Hello, everybody. Carl here with another Aeronautica video. As you can see here, there has been a new update, and it has something to do with supersonic transport. They've added a separate license that you can attempt at this airport over here, southeast of the game map. And the Concorde and the Tupolev Tu-444, both variants, now require this license. And they've added some more supersonic aircraft. And most of them are actually canceled in history. Tu-707, the L-2000, Svesti Solo Chitire, Triste Solo Chitire, and some bug fixes. In this video, we will take the supersonic transport license final exam, and this will be our trainer aircraft, the Tupolev Tu-444. The Tupolev Tu-444. And yes, it's one of those canceled aircraft. Size of a business jet. We'll take note of the stall speed at 170 knots and the service ceiling of 17,000 meters. Alright, let's do the training. The objective is to fly your trainer aircraft to Anhedral International, which is north by northeast of Valois, our current location. And the final exam only costs 100,000 Wingz Points. Shall we? And here is our Chetirista Sorokchetire. Let's have a look at it. And turn on the navigational lights. What a beauty. It's basically a shrunken version of the Tu-444. All right. Our final exam is to transport our vehicle to Anhedral International with two stopovers. And our first one is 361 kilometers away. So let's see the map. If it's Anhedral International, and from Anhedral International, it's only 152 kilometers away, which we're not going there directly. So let's see which airport is closest to the first stopover distance. So it should be around the island chain, 260, 300, 321, 334, and given the distance, it should be around Kitesboro. So is it 355? shouldn't not be armor, but Kitesboro International. So let's enable the runway guide. And let us start the engines. Increase the throttle slightly. And let us taxi to runway 20. So of course this is Valois International Airport on the dead of night. And as you can see here, a few developers in this game have been aware of the slipping issue. It's a Roblox thing, but I hope that Roblox will fix this soon enough. Let's reduce our speed to around 2%. As it is taxi speed. So frustrating, isn't it? You have to keep your mouse pointing at the taxiway to be consistent with proper procedure. So yes, we're going to Kitesboro as our first stopover, so we'll have to take off on the southwest direction and take a turn . I've already tried doing the Valois Kitesboro route on the Boeing 747-8F. That's my previous video. So this is somewhat related to our last flight. So here we are in runway 20. Let's reduce the speed. There we go, and let's align with the runway, despite still being slippery. Game issue. Right, stop right there. Try to align as best we can. Let's align with the runway. There we go. Straight and parallel. There we go. Then we should press the T key to raise the dripping nose, right? That would give an aerodynamic boost. All right. I believe we're ready to take off. So let's get rid of the heads-up display and enjoy the cinematic takeoff. And right bracket to zoom and the camera. And we're off. Annoying, isn't it? And yes, you were thinking you should turn on the afterburners at this point, but I don't think it is practical taking off with afterburners. So we'll do a normal takeoff. Let's climb. Steer right. The moon is beautiful. Whoa, what happened here? Oops, the landing gear. Looks like we're above the cirrus cloud. At least the risk of stalling is reduced. Or less often. There goes the sonic boom. Oops. Oh no. Right. Not bad for a first timer. So. Let's go back to normal. Yes, the risk is always uncertain. It's inevitable. Six, maybe 305. Right, 306. And look how the wind affects the airflow. Not parallel, just to show you the new wind update. 12.1 knot winds from 054. Can we do 311? Yes. Yes, the risk of stalling is inevitable, but at least it can easily be resolved quickly. With skill and experience in controlling the aircraft, all right, I'll be back once we hit 3,000 meters, and we'll restart the engines. So enjoy the glide, everyone. All right, looks like the distance is more than the altitude. So let's start the engines once again. Just catch some steam. Thank you. we go. Now let's try to have a proper landing. Let's lower the nose. Right, we're almost. Right, 25 kilometers away, so we'll need to restart the engines and the line with the runway. Right. Good. Take note that the stall speed is 170 knots. There we go. Now we can apply. There. Disable the wind. There we go. Let's reverse thrust. Gears down. And this is just the beginning. And there seems to be no slipping issues here, so we can taxi as normal. another trainer. And he's also using a Tetavesta, Sorokshatir. Of course, this is a trainer aircraft. Let's see if... Oh? Oh, I forgot to change this back to 10,000. Let's refuel. Yes, my first attempt got interrupted by, so I had to switch the channel. So this is the chat record. Oh, clipping as always. This becomes easier since the second stopover is only 180 kilometers away. So let's see which place has 180 kilometers away. Is it Rawaki? No, that's 131. Is it Oakport? That's too far. Santris? Almost there. Yes, I think it's Enoksen. Yeah, it's Enoksen. So, let's verify by the arrow. That's right. It's our second stopover is at Enoksen International. So, we will have to take off from runway 16. No, not 16. That's Waffles took up on runway 16, so it should be 34. Wait. That would require an S. So yes, so the most logical should be 16. So let's turn on the engines. Let's begin the second leg. And we're going to taxi at runway 16. So throttle slightly. Longer than the jets I usually fly. Fair enough. Let's reduce the throttle to 3%, then to 2%. So we're going to avoid an S maneuver. Or a C. I think it's a C, so before you do C's, and just do a U-turn. So let's try not turning on the afterburners. There's only like 200 kilometers of flight. One, and it should be two, but it was around 25, but oops. Right? Smoother takeoff. Right. Raise the droopy nose. Take off. As much as possible, let's align, keep the plane aligned. There we go. Grease the gears. And yes, this is just a miniaturized two-stroke GTR S. Not bad for a starter plane. always a time for manual controls. Let's go to 358. Or 355. 353. Let's take a dive. Yes, this is a train aircraft. This is supposed to be a train aircraft, so in reality, there should be no passengers aboard. Yes, we can start lowering the nose. There we go. Normally, I would not descend with a vertical speed of more than 30, but for the purposes of this training, we can. And, oh great, another cloud cover. Do 350? Yes. An Atlas. Well, some players believe that the A400M Atlas can do better than the Anspotsetva. Thank you. This is going to be a normal landing procedure, so see you at X then, everyone. Now that the cloud is out of the way, let's restart the engine. Yes, with the nose down. I wonder who would do such a thing. Still waiting for that answer. No matter. Let's keep ourselves to more than 2,000 meters. Freeze the nose for a while. First aligned with the runway. Is that 32? Turn on the navigational lights. It will be 5:30 p.m. gate time. We'll turn time 17:30. Now disable the wind, or what do you call it? The wingtip smoke, yes. Disable the wingtip smoke. Let's align with. Yeah, what was that? 32? Was it 32? Yes. Raise a bit. Right, there we go. We have. We're a bit to the left. We're a bit to the left. So. Right. Right. nose, ears down. Right. So close. Now let's see. Yes, I'd appreciate if there were parachutes to aid in the... Normally, there should be some parachutes that are deployed behind the aircraft. That's a good suggestion. As you can see, like the airports at the large continent of Avalon, Enoksen and Kyrgyzstan are slippery. Again, game issue, or yeah, it's simply a Roblox issue, not just a game issue. Stop at the fuel tank rather than near the terminal. There we go. Continue to the next airport. Refueling. Right, where's the next airport? It's 301. 95 kilometers, so. So yes, we're headed to Anhedral International right now, so this one, the runway directions are tricky here. It's southwest northeast. So how do we? Yes, we could. We should take either runway here. Oh, what's this? Okay, here. Alright, so we can choose to land it at runway 21 left or 21 right. They're parallel. But since it's in close proximity to Anhedral City Airport, let's do 31 right. Yeah, 20. Let's do 21 right. Did I say 31? It's 21 right. And Waffle Summer. Is that his name? Yeah, Waffle Summer. Is still using the afterburners. And it's descending too fast. So we'll have to use the afterburners. So let us start the engines once more. Let's be on our way to Anhedral International. So let's take off from runway 14. Shoulder. Where's the Atlas? Oh, there's the Atlas ones too. Oh, the Atlas took off from the taxiway. Practical. Right, let's just wait for the Atlas to leave the airspace. But I guess we got the point here. Quality's lower here. Yes. So let's try to lower the graphics temporarily. Let's see if this works. Alright, let's. We don't want to slow down for about some lips. Once again, we'll wait until he has 2,000 meters before we can take off. Want to give me a 100,000 Wingz Points loan. Alright, I think this is right timing, so let's full speed ahead. Line. Can't afford any going off the runway.
Thank God. one of them.
Right.
Thank you.
transport train in P 100,000.
Yes, that's
the cost of the point of exam. That's a big change for the cost of the training of all aircraft. Except 50,000 of these solutions. Around 10,000. I think this is a practical way of work. Just close the first block right there. So we will be landing at center view. 21 right. Yes, it should be 21 right. And yeah, not again. War cloud cover. Good. Which Russian supersonic transport? Thank you.
There we go. Now we can see good view of Anhedral. Proper. Looks unreal without the wingtip smoke. Doesn't it? We'll disable this once we turn on the engines. That's 151. Looks like London, isn't it? Yep. Looks like London. City Airport. That should be the international. Alright, November 4-5, Sierra November is on final runway 21 right. Let's do the manual steering. And let's restart the engines. We're close to 2,000 meters right now. Let's check the graphics settings. Great. Add one more controller. All you. Let's disable the smoke. Oh, 2-1 left.
turn the volume. To one right. Should go to one right. Okay, let's lower the quality once again. So much. How about that? Gears down. Straighten out. Let's see if the flipping persists. Does. And there we go. Supersonic transport license, and our trainer aircraft is the Tupolev Tu-444, the Tupolev Tu-444. Right, see you on the next video, or you can just enjoy taking this plane to the nearest fuel stop to the Orange Arrow.